Hello friends, this is Professor Afaq Ahmed. In this video, we are going to study automotive engineering. My friends, in previous video, we have started with basic components of automobile. And this video, we will be studying with different types of automobiles, different types of IC engines, and each part of IC engine in detail. So let's start. First, we will discuss about different types of automobiles. Automobiles are generally divided into two different parts. First is passenger vehicle, second is goods vehicle. Passenger vehicle is again divided into two different types, light vehicles and heavy vehicles. Light vehicles is again divided into 5-6 different types, autocycles or mopeds, scooters, motorcycles, jeep, station wagons, pickups and car, wherein heavy vehicles are divided into two different types, buses and coaches. Next is goods vehicles. Goods vehicles are again divided into two different types. First is light vehicles, second is heavy vehicles. Light vehicles are again divided into three different types, delivery van, light truck and tempo, wherein heavy vehicles are divided into truck and tractor trailer. In thermodynamics and engineering, a heat engine is a system that converts heat or thermal energy and chemical energy to mechanical energy, which can then be used to do mechanical work. The mechanical work often involves powering generator, which converts the mechanical energy to electrical energy. It does this by bringing a working substance from higher state temperature to lower state temperature. A heat source generates thermal energy that brings working substance to the higher temperature state. The working substance generates work in the working body of an engine while transferring heat to the colder sink until it reaches to low temperature state. During this process, some of the thermal energy is converted into the work by exploiting the properties of working substance. The working substance can be any system with a non-zero heat capacity, but it is usually is a gas or liquid. During this process, lot of heat is lost to the surrounding and so cannot be converted into the work. Next is internal combustion engine, that is IC engine, is a heat engine where the combustion of a fuel occurs with an oxidizer, usually air, in a combustion chamber that is an integral part of the working fluid. In an internal combustion engine, the expansion of the high temperature and low temperature pressure gases produced by combustion applies direct force to some component of the engine. The force applied at typically piston, turbine blades, rotor and nozzle. IC engine is basically divided according to five different criteria. First is according to ignition. According to ignition, it is divided into spark ignition, that is auto, and compression ignition, that is called as diesel. Next is according to the working cycle, it is divided into two strokes and four strokes. According to the fueling, it is divided into the compression ignition, which is again divided into indirect ignition and direct ignition, wherein spark ignition is divided into the carburetor ignition, port ignition, direct ignition. According to the cooling, it is air cooling and liquid cooling. According to the air intake, it is naturally aspired, and second is supercharged. Now, we will start with internal combustion engine mechanism, its parts and its working. Now the mechanism and parts are as follows. First is valve rocker, then valve spring, third valve. Two valves are there, inlet valve and exhaust valve. Sparking plug, that is spark plug, piston, water jacket, gudgeon pin, cylinder, connecting rod, balance weight, then crankshaft, camshaft chain driven from the camshaft, then cam, then tappet, and last is the push rod. In IC engine, we have to take the inlet. Through the inlet valve, we are taking air fuel mixture, wherein air fuel mixture during the suction stroke of the piston, moves from top dead center to the bottom dead center, wherein the suction stroke will be completed and the air fuel mixture will be getting inside. After that, the piston will move from bottom dead center to the top dead center when the compression stroke will be completed and spark will be produced. Due to combustion of a fuel, the motion of the piston will be starting from top dead center to the bottom dead center, and during the last stroke the piston will again move from bottom dead center to the top dead center, wherein the exhaust gases will be expelled out. Now we will see all the parts one by one. First part is a cylinder. A cylinder is the central working part of reciprocating engine or pump, the space in which piston travels. Multiple cylinder engines are commonly arranged side by side in a bank or engine block, which is typically cast from aluminium or cast iron before receiving precision machine work. Cylinder may be sleeved, lined with harder material, or sleeveless, which is wear resistance coating such as Nikasil. A sleeveless engine may also be referred to parent bore engine. Second part is cylinder head. In an internal combustion engine, the cylinder head, often informally abbreviated to just, sits above the cylinder on the top of the cylinder block. It closes in top of the cylinder, forming the combustion chamber. This joint is sealed by head gasket. In most engines, the head also provides space for passages that feed air and fuel to the cylinder, and that allows the exhaust to escape. The head can also be placed to the mount, the valves, spark plugs, and fuel injectors. Now the third part is piston. Piston is a component of reciprocating engine, reciprocating pump, gas compressor, and pneumatic cylinder, among other similar mechanism. It is a moving component that is contained by a cylinder and is made gas tight by piston rings. In an engine, its purpose is to transfer force from expanding gases in the cylinder to the crankshaft via a piston rod and or connecting rod. In a pump, the function is reversed. The force is transmitted from the crankshaft to the piston for the purpose of compressing or ejecting the fluid in a cylinder. In some engine, the piston also act as a valve by converting or covering and uncovering ports in the cylinder. Now next part is piston rings. Piston ring is a split ring that fits into a groove on outer diameter of a piston in a reciprocating engine such as IC engine or steam engine. The main functions of piston rings in reciprocating engines are, first is sealing the combustion chamber so that there is minimal losses of the gases to the crankcase. Second is to improving heat transfer from the piston to the cylinder wall. Third is to maintain the proper quantity of the oil between the piston and the cylinder wall. Fourth is regulating engine oil consumption by scrapping oil from the cylinder walls back to the sump. The gap of the piston ring compressed to few thousands of inches, which inside the cylinder bore. Piston rings are major factor in identifying if engine is
two-stroke or four-stroke. Three piston rings suggest that it is four-stroke engine, while two piston rings suggest that it is two-stroke engine. Most of the rings are made up of very hard, in somewhat it is brittle cast iron material.
Next part is gudgeon pin. In internal combustion engines, the gudgeon pin connects the piston to the connecting rods, okay, and provides a bearing for connecting rod to the pivot upon the piston moves. In very early engine designs, including those driven by steam, were also many large stationary or marine engines, the gudgeon pin is located in a sliding crosshead that connects to the piston via rod. A gudgeon is a pivot or a journal. The origin of the word gudgeon is Middle English word gojon, which is originated from the Middle French word gojon. Its first known use was in 15th century. The gudgeon pin is typically four short hollow rod made of steel alloy, high strength and hardness that may physically separate it from both the connecting rod and the piston or crosshead. Now next and sixth part is connecting rod. Connecting rod is a rigid member which connects a piston to crank or crankshaft in a reciprocating engine. Together with a crank, it forms a simple mechanism that converts reciprocating motion into rotary motion. A connecting rod may also convert rotating motion into the reciprocating motion. Its original use. Earlier mechanism such as chain could only impart pulling motion. Being rigid, a connecting rod may transmit either pull or push, allowing the rod to rotate the crank through both halves of the revolution. In few stroke engine and generally two stroke engine, the connecting rod is only used required to push. Today, connecting rod is the best known, though its use in internal combustion engine, piston engine such as automobile engines. Now seventh part is crankshaft. A crankshaft related to crank is a mechanical part able to perform conversion between reciprocating motion and rotary motion. In a reciprocating engine, it is translating and reciprocating motion of the piston into the rotational motion, whereas in reciprocating compressor, it converts rotational motion into reciprocating motion. In order to do the conversion between two motions, the crankshaft, crank throws or crank pins, additionally bearing surfaces whose axis is offset that the crank, which is the big ends of the connecting rods from each cylinder attached. It is typically connected to flywheel to reduce pulsation characteristic of four stroke cycle, and sometimes a torsional or vibrational damper at the opposite end to reduce the torsional vibration often caused along the length of the crankshaft by cylinders farthest from the output end acting on torsional elasticity of the metal. Now the last part remaining is called as inlet and exhaust valves. Inlet valve is used to take air fuel mixture inside the cylinder during the suction stroke, wherein exhaust valve is to release the gases, which is combustible fluid, to the atmosphere during the exhaust stroke. Thank you very much for watching my videos. I would like to say that if you like my videos, kindly comment on it and share, subscribe, as well as press bell icon to get the new updates about my upcoming videos. Thank you very much, guys.